Hey, welcome back to the Six Figure Mastermind. Man, if you know anything about six figure business, you know about the Google Docs app, but I want to teach you how to use it today and why it's so essential for your business. So stay tuned. If you've seen me before, you know I'm a huge advocate of Google Docs wherever you go. You've got to have it on your desktop, and you most definitely have to have it on your phone. So I'm just going to walk you through the quick tutorial about how to use Google Docs on your phone. It does work just a little bit differently because the interface is slightly modified for a mobile device, but it works very intuitively at the same time. So first things first, you're going to open up your device, go to the Google Play Store or the App Store or wherever you buy your apps, and get the free download of Google Docs. Once you've got that, open it up because I'm going to walk you through it right here. So I keep all of my Google stuff in one place. I got my calendar, my Google Maps, my photos, rewards, draw, everything is just all together. It's my little Google headquarters. So I've got my Google Docs and I'm going to open this up. Now what I love, love, love about Google Docs is that it automatically updates and integrates with everything I've done on Google Docs, no matter where I've done it. I have had so many instances where I needed to print off a document and I would have been in huge trouble if that document were sitting on a hard drive on my computer in my office, because I'll be hundreds or thousands of miles away and I need that print off. This is why I use Google Docs for everything. So when I open it up on my phone, it's got a little bit different of an interface than you'll see on the desktop version. So here I've got a few different documents that have been recently opened, and I'm just going to go with the example of this brochure we created for another one of our videos. Now this brochure, it looks very similar to the one we saw online, except the formatting again is for the desktop, or excuse me, for the mobile device. So your text is going to appear in a little bit different place. Your layout's going to appear a little bit differently. That's okay. All your information is still going to be there. You can still add people to this document. If you see this little guy up top with a plus sign next to him, I can add people to this document. I can still say if they can edit, if they can comment, or if they can view. I can message people when I send that invitation out. And once I do that, I click the little airplane and sends it right over to them. Whether or not they have a Gmail account, it doesn't matter. Obviously, if they do have a Gmail account, they're probably already going to have Google Docs, and then they'll have access to this document whenever they need it. If they don't have a Gmail account, then as long as they have the link, they'll still have access. So that's the first item. The second item is this comment. So I can click on this box right up here, and then I'm going to see all the comments that were made previously, whether the comments were made on a desktop or whether the comments were made on a mobile device. So I can see all of those comments right there. Swipe down, those comments go away, and this magic little three dots, this ellipse up here, that's where all the yumminess happens. This is most of your interface right over here. So I can see it in a print layout. I can suggest changes. Remember how we, on our other video, if you haven't seen it, go watch it. The desktop, how to make changes and create Google documents and all that fun stuff. I can suggest changes in here, which means whatever I edit will show up as a suggestion rather than a change. And you can either accept or reject those suggestions. Okay, I'm gonna turn that off and go to document outline. This is super, super handy, especially if you have a multi-page document with headers and things. You don't want to have to scroll through. I had a 24-page document that was our playbook for a four-day event, and I needed to find things quickly. So I created this outline so that I could easily and effortlessly go through and find the bullet points that were specific to what I was looking for. Okay, once I go over here, I can find and replace, so I can use a... Maybe I need to find, we change the name of the program, for example. If you're creating a program for your business and you change the name, but you already formed the document, you can go look up the old name, search it, and replace it with whatever you're needing. Over here we have Explorer, I never use that one. Word count, not really necessary unless you're writing a book. Page setup, you can do that for if you're using a printer. You've got your details here. It's just got your history on there. Share and export. Now this is one of my favorite things. Once again, link sharing. You can compress your whole document into a link, have that link, copy it, send it out. You can send a copy of this document. You can print this document if you've got connected to an air printer. You can save it as a Word doc, make a copy. Let's say you want to make a copy because you have a newsletter and you want to duplicate it and just change the content. That's so easy to do. Okay, help and feedback. Again, I hardly ever use that. You can make it available offline. If you do that, this is important. If you make this available offline, that means it will save a copy to your phone so you can access it. Let's say you lose your signal or you're not connected to Wi-Fi. If this is available offline, then you have access to it on your phone. All right. Basically, Google Docs has made it very simple for you to get what you need no matter where you are. You can also share this and email it. So if I were to share an export and I wanted to send a copy, I can choose whether or not I can send it as a PDF or if I want to send it as a Word doc. Remember, this is different from sharing this document. If I'm going to share this document, that's going to mean that I can have other people edit it with me. But if I'm just going to send a copy, that either means I'm going to send it as a PDF, meaning it's uneditable, untouchable by the recipient, or I can send it as a Word doc, which they can then download to their computer. If I send it as a Word doc, that means they're downloading it to their computer, and any changes they make within the Word document are not going to show up on the Google Drive document. Okay, if you're the only way to see each other's changes is to keep it as a shared link or a shared document. That's the only way to do that. So Google Docs is a very simple, very easy to use interface on your device. It does look a little different. You're still going to find your folders with your drive items, with all your photos and all your linked attachments. You're still going to find the ability to sort and change it, whether you want to view it by most recently opened or by most recently modified or just by name, by title. Again, if you don't have Google Docs on your phone and you're running a business, six figures or on its way, go to your phone, download it right now. This is a must-have for you. Hey, thanks for watching today. Hope you enjoyed today's video. If you have any questions about Google, Google Docs, Google Sheets, all of that, drop me a line below. I want to answer all your questions, and make sure you hit that subscribe button so you can see the answers. I'll see you tomorrow.